Hey guys, what's going on? It's Tyler from Nelly Security, and today I don't have any lights or fancy camera gear or anything like that going because I want to talk about these fluorescent lights up here. I know you've had this experience. You go to install a camera indoors and you end up with something like this annoying flicker caused by these fluorescent lights. It's actually a really simple reason for this and an even simpler fix. To understand what's causing these lights to flicker, you first have to understand AC currents. In the United States and elsewhere in the world. We actually have a blog post about the difference between AC and DC currents, which I will link down in the description below. But in a nutshell, what you really need to know for this video is that AC stands for alternating current. The AC standard in the United States is 60 hertz. Pretty much everywhere else in the world, the standard is 50 hertz. When we are talking about these fluorescent lights operating on an AC current of 60 hertz in the United States, these lights are actually pulsing 120 times per second. Now, if we were in pretty much anywhere else in the world where the standard is 50 hertz, these lights would be pulsing on and off 100 times per second. And that is the root of the issue here with these UniView cameras, which were not developed in the United States and by default are not set up for 60 hertz operation. Let's hop into the image settings here and I will show you what I'm talking about. We'll go to setup and image, and you can see right away in this little preview image here, you see that flicker? That is annoying, so let's fix that. To do that, we're going to pop open this exposure tab, and you can see in here that this exposure mode is set to indoor at 50 hertz. Which would make sense if we were anywhere in the world outside of the United States, but we're not. So let's change this to indoor 60 hertz, and boom, those flickers disappear instantly. Check that out. Super easy fix. Now, if you have a camera that is flickering like this and it doesn't have these exposure mode settings, if it just has automatic and manual, let me show you how to fix this manually. If we come into manual, you can see that the shutter speed is set to 1 over 60. If I change this instead to 1 over 50, boom, you can see we have these flickers again. If I change this to 120, the flickering stops. If I change this to 100, it flickers. So the key here is, if you have to set this manually, to set the shutter speed where this bottom number is divisible by 120. So we can set the shutter speed to 1 over 120, it's fine. We can set the shutter speed to 1 over 160 and it's fine. Or we can set the shutter speed, that's hard to say. Or we can set the shutter speed to 1 over 30 and it's fine. Pretty much anything else, 1 over 25 is going to give us flickers. 1 over 50 is going to give us flickers. And 1 over 100 is gonna give us flickers. Something to keep in mind here also is your frame rate. So if we come in here to video and check out what our frame rate is, right now it is 25, but we could set this up to 30. So let's do that. And now with our frame rate at 30, we can come in here and manually set our shutter speed to 1 over 160. That's gonna give us really nice fluid motion. So we now have this shutter speed as 2 times the frame rate of this camera. And also it's divisible by the 120, which is the amount of times these fluorescent lights pulse per second. I hope that makes sense. If you are not in the United States, basically you can ignore everything I just said, and you will want to set this to 50 hertz or 1 over 50, 1 over 100. All right, guys, that was just a quick video. I hope it was helpful for you, and I hope you learned a thing or two. If you did, be sure to like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us across social media so you never miss another security video. Happy installing, and I will catch you in the next one.